For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Client Names 1 from your sample files folder. Up until now, we've been using Flash Fill to extract delimited data into discrete data elements. For example, we used Flash Fill to split Jessica Sagan in one cell into two separate cells, one containing the name Jessica and one containing the name Sagan. In this lesson, we're going to use Flash Fill to not split text, but concatenate text. Let me show you what I mean by concatenation. Cells A4, B4 and C4 contain three pieces of text: Sagan, Elizabeth, Jessica. In cell D4, I'm now going to concatenate them by typing Sagan space Elizabeth space Jessica. You can see that all concatenation means is to take text values from several separate cells, add a delimiter next to each value, and place the result in a single cell. In this case, I've taken the three discrete pieces of data, Sagan, Elizabeth, and Jessica, and then I've put a space in between each piece of data to produce Sagan space Elizabeth space Jessica. This type of concatenation is very simple, and Flash Fill finds it very easy to perform. But we're going to push Flash Fill to the very limits of its power in this lesson by giving it a problem to solve that seems at first to be almost insolvable. Let's delete Sagan Elizabeth Jessica from this cell, and in cell D3 we'll type the header formatted name. And let's consider how we'd like the name Sagan Elizabeth Jessica to be formatted in quite a complex way. Let's have Sagan, the surname first, then a comma, then a space, then the first name, and then a space, and then a capital letter showing the initial of the middle name, and finally, a full stop. Now that seems like quite a complicated problem, but you can see that for Flash Fill, it's going to be impossible for it to work with the remainder of the data. For example, on row 5, Stephen Bell doesn't have a middle name. He has an initial, and the initial's lowercase. So how can Flash Fill possibly guess what we want to do with that? And look at John Jennings. He doesn't have a middle name at all, and his last name has a lowercase j. How can Flash Fill figure out what result we'd like for John Jennings? Well, just for fun, let's give Flash Fill the impossible task and see what it makes of all this data. So, I'll click Home tab on the ribbon, Editing Group, Fill, and Flash Fill. Well, Flash Fill's had a shot at the problem, but it's not done very well. In the case of Stephen Bell, it's got the first name and last name okay, but it's really messed up with the middle name. It just didn't know what to do with that lowercase p. And with John Jennings, I can't imagine where it's got an O from. And the first letter of Jennings is lowercase, because Flash Fill's guessed that I want to keep the original formatting. It's the same with the last three names. Really, Flash Fill hasn't done well. But it's not Flash Fill's fault. It's our fault for not telling Flash Fill what's needed. So let's give Flash Fill another hint. I'll take away those bad names. And in the case of Stephen P. Bell, I'll ask Flash Fill to produce the name Bell, comma, Stephen, and then a capital P and a full stop. That should help Flash Fill do a better job. Let's try. Home tab on the ribbon, in the editing group, Fill and Flash Fill. Look what Flash Fill's done this time. It said, on the information you've given me, I don't have a problem with row 7. And it's got that completely correct. And I can also figure out what to do with row 9, because that's very similar to Stephen Bell. But Flash Fill is saying, I haven't got a clue what you want me to do with John Jennings and Alfred Hawkin. So it's left the cells blank. Let's tell Flash Fill how we'd like John Jennings to be formatted. Well, I'll go for Jennings with a capital J, then a comma, and then John with a capital J. And I'll press the Enter key. And look what's happened. Flashfill has said, aha, now I know how to format John Jennings. I'm quite happy that I also know how to format Alfred Hawking. And what seems to be an almost insolvable task has been completely solved by Flashfill. You can see that in this lesson, Flashfill was able to work its magic because we gave it three separate examples of how we wanted it to treat different formatted names in the source cells. This is called multiple example Flashfill. You can now begin to appreciate how immensely powerful Flashfill is. But we're not finished yet. In the next lesson, I'm going to demonstrate some even more incredible things you can do with Flashfill. But for the moment, all that remains is to save your work. And I'm going to save with the new name, Client Names 2. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 220. Use multiple example Flashfill to concatenate text.